Okay, you're watching Exclusive Access with your girl, Sheila Gashumbe, and today we decide to invent the photo shoot of a brand's campaign. He's been having this campaign for so long now. It's called the Dress for Success, and he's been using different celebrities, trying to teach them to dress for success. No one is leaving their houses looking like, you know, they are broke or something. But I'm inviting today, and I want to have a chit-chat with a few of them. I can see Jackie O in the building. You can see Judith Hurd, all looking glammed up. I don't know what's really going on here. I can see a brand. I can see Roger Mugisha, the makeup artist, Zypa in the building. Lights, camera, and fashion was the theme of this scene. I caught up with some of the celebrities in a quick chat with some ear-dropping information that you didn't know. Hi, how are you?
Hi, Sheila.
You're looking beautiful.
I wish I could look like you.
Come on. Sweet 18. Judith, don't make me no younger. So tell me, who are your five hottest celebrities in Uganda and international-wise?
Roger Mugisha. Mm-hmm. I hope I don't get beat for this.
Emrons,
Zypa, and
international wife?
French Montana, Tyrese.
Okay. Yeah. So Roger, what do you think attracts ladies to you? I'm sure you know yourself. This guy always looks like, you know, yeah, money.
Okay, first of all, I'm flattered that coming from you. Thank you so much. I guess it's just when you get good designers like like Brian dressing you up like this, Abrams, you things just happen.
Okay.
So blame it on the suit.
We know you as a fashionista and want to know which blunders you literally get irritated of when you see them in Uganda.
I hate when I see a thick lady stuck in a dress that my daughters can wear.
Oh,
everything is out there hanging. If you want to wear something short, make sure it's the right size. The male celebrities are stuck on one style. All they know is a t-shirt,
chain,
gold, like 60 of them, jeans, and then some Nike. I think they're supposed to be wearing Jordans.
There's been this Gisele Luzinda saga, and you know, what do you think about it? Because we've seen some time back when you were in the same kind of situation. We want to get to know your side of view about Gisele Luzinda.
I think it's any woman, not just me or Gisele Luzinda, any woman any person that puts any woman's nude pictures out, I just cast them because, respect, you have a mother. You have a wife, probably you have a girlfriend. Would you be happy if somebody else exposed your girlfriend?
Roger, I want to get to know your views because I saw your view on Facebook.
Oh, okay.
And I want you to share it with us on TV.
No, I just think it's people are abusing Facebook as social media, and Facebook should be a place. It should have community. Their community standards, and Ugandans, they're taking to the, they're taking it to be a marketplace. Everybody brings their lawlessness, harassment, bullying, and all that, which is very wrong. It's a wrong place, and I know that a lot of people are trying to fix that now and realizing that it's being abused, and very soon you're going to get a lot of regulations regulating Facebook. But it's bullying. It is bullying. I mean, why? Actually, if I was in my real view about what happened to Desire is I blame whoever sent you the pictures. Whoever saw the pictures, blame the person who sent them to you. That's their fault. Those were not your pictures.
What do you do when you wake up? Don't say you pray.
When you wake up? Check my WhatsApp.
Your WhatsApp. See what's happening in the world. There's a lot of Lugambo on WhatsApp. You guys on WhatsApp, you're going to kill people. Right next to the, the Uganda's best photographer, voted by all of you guys last year at the Abraham Style and Fashion Awards. Hi.
Hi, Sheila, how are you?
I'm good. You know, I always fail to say your name. Maybe today I will learn on the screen.
Is it Giulio.
Giulio Molfese. Molfese. Which country is that? Because you know for us it's tribes, and for you?
Yeah, originally I'm from Italy.
Oh, okay. Some Italian food. How do they say Italiano?
Pasta, pizza, spaghetti. Yeah.
I like lasagna.
I know you like lasagna. Everyone does in the world.
Yeah, I love lasagna. So tell me, as a fashion, you know, photographer, you've been here. How long have you been in Uganda for?
10 years.
Now. 10 years. Ah, you're Ugandan. Je baleko sebo. Yeah, he's Ugandan. What do you love about, you know, fashion in Uganda? I'm sure you've seen it grow. 10 years. Where do you think Uganda is now?
Uganda fashion is growing up. It's still a long way to go, but there are a lot of talents coming up as designers, stylists, there are new schools and new designers coming up every year. You see some new ones like Marta Jabbo, that she's quite young but she's very talented, and many others, of course. So it's growing up.
What do you think about the Ebra and Stellan Fashion Award?
Well, it's a nice idea that he has, and of course he's trying to push this idea of fashion awards. And I hope that one day there will be one big committee or one big entity to organize a united fashion awards. Yeah.
What can't you do without in your life?
Photography, art. Art, photography is a creation.
If I took it away, you're dead.
Well, it's a process of creation. You know, even without a camera, I can see you and I see you in photographic terms. I can see how the lights falls on you, the shadows. So it's something that I do constantly, even without a camera.
Wow. We also heard you're dating one of models in Uganda. Is it true?
Private life is private life.
Okay, private life is private. You know, let me let him do his work. Exclusive access, we get you all the photos that no one has. When I say no one, I say it's only Sheila Gashumba that was in the building. We get you things like behind the scenes of your favorite music artists, what are your celebrities doing, and you know, link us with us on NTV The Beat. Tell me where you want me to go, yeah, I will be right there. And on Twitter, NTV The Beat. But you know, for now, let me enter this post right there.